We're here in Nashville, Tennessee at the iGel Disrupt 2020 event, and I'm speaking with Nico of Liquid. Can you tell me a little bit about the company and what, how you fit into the EUC space?
So Liquid is a Dutch company founded 5 years ago, and we are focusing on aggregating every single application, every single resource there is in IT, into one single pane of glass for the end user. So we try to automate and contextualize IT for the end user to make it as easy as possible, while giving the IT admins full control over all resources.
And so how specifically do you work with iGel or partner with them?
Well, iGel is a thin client delivering solution, and most companies use more than one virtualization platform. So they might just have Citrix, and they have something like VMware, or want to move to WVD, for instance.
Right.
So we are able to make that move seamlessly. So we give her a launch pad, and we can point users in the right direction, while never have the feeling that they have to switch over or do any manual work.
Oh, that's great. And I understand you have a demo that you brought with you that we could maybe take a look at?
Of course, yeah.
All right, that would be great.
Should I pick it up?
Yeah.
So, here you see our launch pad. I guess you can see it.
Yeah.
Our launch pad. What you see here is just a browser-based solution. So what we can offer is every type of application. So physical applications, legacy applications, on-premise or whatever in the cloud. And then we aggregate every single application into a portal. So the thing you see here is an aggregation of physical applications, software as a service applications, but also Citrix applications, which is transparent for the end user. And I can just fire up any application at any time at any location. And Liquid will adapt to the user's needs. So for instance, I have here the application Microsoft Excel. I click on Excel, and now it will launch Excel online because I'm in a remote office. I don't have access to my data.
Right.
So in this case, I can still work, but of course with a little limitations. But Liquid follows a workflow. So what we can do with this, we create smart icons. And this icon will tell me a story. So Liquid would first start looking Excel 2016 locally on my machine, but my context doesn't allow me to run that application. So next up would be looking for the native Excel application, because if on my iPad, I want to run a native application that would give me the best performance, the best experience for an end user. But I'm not an iPad, so rule that one out. And the last one now is Excel Online. So constantly adapting to it. We place filters on every single action. So I have here my Excel Apple One. There's a filter on it, and it says, well, you can only run this task if you're on an iOS device. In any other case, just simply skip this task and we'll go to the next one. This could be any task, so we can perform this also for Citrix. When we are deploying those applications, so this one is not deploying, but if we are deploying applications, it can be on the local machine, but we are also able to deploy within your Citrix session and then control, monitor, and redirect everything within your Citrix session. Then we are the workspace management solution. So Liquid is basically a deployment solution. So we deploy golden images, deploy a local image on a device. It is an application distribution mechanism, and we aggregate every single resource for IT with single sign-on to anywhere.
So it's kind of like a smart icon that kind of, instead of bringing you directly to the application, now you have a set of rules that you can follow to get you to the most efficient and
most efficient way to get the best user experience without the user having to think about what should I do. So for instance, if I want to work from home, you got two things to do. Or you got to start a Citrix session that I need to know the URL, or I set up a VPN connection. In both cases, there's something as an end user I don't want to do. So what we do, we bring you just a site, you log onto it, and then we will perform all tasks for you. An IT admin can set the specific scenarios with every filter, every task in between. And then we can just connect the printers, drive mapping, sets, registry settings, ODBC settings, manage everything that's just for the end user.
Great.
So if I look at another application, here I have 7-Zip. So 7-Zip now launches locally because I have a laptop. The thing is, when I'm a new user, I'm unaware of what kind of device I'm using. So what I want to see, I want to have is my application. I don't want to think about it. So what we do in this scenario, we created a smart icon with an application distribution in it. So here are two MSIs. One is MSI is for the 32-bit mechanism, so there's a filter on 32-bit. And the other one is a 64-bit mechanism. So it's a different MSI with the same application in it. As a user, I simply select my application and we will decide what application will fit on your device. Then we will install that application. And after we see it's installed on your device, we will give you a start the application. But if it's not available to be installed in this scenario, we just fire up an RDP session. So the user can still do his work, still be redirected to the correct resource, and everything will run just fine without the user having to do any interaction whatsoever. And then again on the front end, you have the freedom to choose. So we can deploy your applications just in your start menu taskbar. We also interconnect with every other solution. So we have a Microsoft Teams app available, where Microsoft Teams is your collaboration communication platform. The one thing missing out in Microsoft Teams, for instance, is your enterprise application store. So we integrate it in. And as soon as the user fires up this Microsoft Teams, we will know where the user is coming from, what the user is doing, what kind of device he's using, and we'll show up the right applications. But we also can see, do I need to patch my system? Do I need to update something? Is my device secure? Yes or no? So then we can make decisions. Should I launch a remote session? Can I do it locally? Or do I need to patch something? Do I need to upgrade something? And redirect the user in any case, in any time, at any place, to give the optimal result for the end user.
That's great. So where can our viewers go if they want to find out more information about Liquid?
They can go to our website, liquid.com. Of course, follow us on Twitter. And they can contact me personally on LinkedIn.
Great. Well, thanks for taking the time to speak with VMBlog.
You're welcome. Thank you.